Hey guys, today we're checking out a budget-friendly 4K 75-inch Android TV from Prism Plus. I know, budget-friendly 4K and 75-inch TV is not something you'd normally go with in the same sentence, but bear with me. We'll go over the specs, how it performs, and to see if this TV is worth your money. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. Who is Prism Plus, you might ask? Well, this is a local Singapore brand that's been supplying the country with monitors for a few years now, and last year they've ventured into a TV market as well. This year, they have doubled down and introduced a new Q-series TVs that mark a milestone for the company as they are the first Singaporean company to feature an Android TV. This TV comes in three sizes, ranging from 55 to 75 inches to suit most households in terms of sizes and price. Android TV has a few nice benefits up its sleeve. First and foremost, it is access to apps, over 7,000 of them, and the list keeps on growing. These include music streaming apps like Spotify and Google Play Music, video streaming apps like Netflix, Prime Video, and YouTube, as well as games. Some are simple that you can play using your remote, and for others you may need a controller. There's also an option to stream games directly from your PC, if you're a more hardcore gamer. Before we get into the main testing, let's quickly cover some of the features. By the way, most of these features are the same across all three sizes. As I mentioned earlier, this is a 4K display. It is actually an IPS panel that gives you great viewing angles. It is running at a standard 60Hz refresh rate and supports 10-bit color. This display has a feature called Motion Estimation and Motion Compensation, MEMC for short. This technology is artificially inserting frames to a video that has a lower frame rate to make it feel a bit smoother. In some scenarios like watching sports, this is a very welcome addition. In others, like for example movies, I prefer it turned off. This way I can enjoy the movie as the director really envisioned it. This is of course a matter of preference. Other features include 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 5.0, which is paired with a Bluetooth remote, as well as support for devices like keyboards, mice, headphones, and game controllers, or even Bluetooth soundbars. It also has support for HDR10 and Dolby Vision, as well as Dolby Audio with true surround sound. Thanks to the included Android TV operating system, we get access to Google Home with voice control, as well as Chromecast, so you can share your content from your PC or mobile device very quickly. As far as all the connections are concerned, these include two HDMI 2.0 ports, one HDMI ARC port, one USB 3.0 and one USB 2.0 ports, AV in, optical audio out, as well as an Ethernet LAN port. This 75-inch unit has all the ports on the side rather than the back. This means that mounting bracket is not obscured. If you want to mount it, it supports 600 by 400 VESA brackets. Keep in mind that due to its size, you will need a bracket and probably a wall that can support 29 kilos. It might also be noted that the power connection is on the opposite side from the ports, and the included power cable is a little bit short. If you're placing it on a TV console, then you probably will be fine. But if you want to plug it directly into the wall, unless the wall plug is right next to it, you may need an extension. Now, let's jump into the testing. It is important to calibrate our expectations here. Prism Plus are not advertising these TVs as top-of-the-line kind. The focus here is to be good value. I think that is essential to keep in mind. I feel like the color performance would normally make or break any TV. We found that this panel delivers great results and the colors are looking natural and vivid, without looking overly saturated. This panel supports over 1 billion colors, so it has the ability to render images with a great precision. We spent a lot of time checking if there are any stuck or dead pixels on the panel. It is funny how long it takes to check it properly. It was at this moment I realized how big this screen actually is. Luckily for us, all the pixels passed the test. We also did a light bleed test where we've turned off all the ambient lights and played a pitch black video in full screen. In the perfect world, you want it to be completely black, just like it is on an OLED TV. The next best thing is uniformity. This one did have a little hotspot on the top right corner. However, unless you intend to sit in a completely dark room and watch a movie about a black wall, then it is unlikely to affect your experience. Also, we have to mention that the camera picks up the light spot better in comparison to a naked eye. And while watching the content, we did not notice anything out of the ordinary. Right after picture quality comes sound. The speakers are downwards firing and get pretty loud. Quality is generally okay unless you turn them up all the way. But I would strongly advise anyone buying TV of any kind, to be honest, to get a proper soundbar. Spending even a few hundred dollars will have an exponential improvement in sound quality, simply because soundbar has more space to actually produce the sound. Moving on with the tests, it is nice to see that the menu system is pretty straightforward. You get options to adjust sound, video profiles, as well as making your own. There's also ability to have automatic sleep timer and screensaver if that's something you're into. Generally, it has everything a normal user would need. Earlier in the video, I did also mention gaming, and it is very nice to play games on a screen of this size. Not every game is suitable, but for example, adventure and exploring type games are really immersive. Do bear in mind that this is still a TV, and it is not suitable for competitive gamers. For that, you will need a monitor with a low input lag and also much faster refresh rate. Other than that, I'm sure you'll enjoy spending some evenings totally engulfed in the fantasy world. One issue that we've stumbled across was boot up times. From the moment you press the button, you have to wait what feels like forever until it is ready to go. Fortunately, there is a workaround. If you go to the TV settings, you'll find a fast boot mode. Once enabled, our boot time was reduced to under 5 seconds. To summarize, what do we think about this TV, and is it worth your money? I believe any of these Q-series TVs would be a great addition to most households, as it delivers great visuals paired with flexibility of an Android TV. Yes, there are TVs out there that are better, but they're also considerably more expensive. And just to think that the pricing of this TV is a fraction of a usual high-end TVs, we were pleasantly surprised to realize that we could not find anything on this TV that was particularly bad. It is a wonderful time to be a couch potato. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to smash that thumbs up and subscribe for more, and we'll see you guys in the next one.